HTC Wildfire is a smaller and lower cost alternative to all those premium smartphones. The question is it cheap and cheerful, or just cheap and nasty? There's no hiding this phone's design influences. It's the baby brother to the HTC design in just about every possible way. The only significant difference between the two on the surface, apart from size, is the buttons underneath the screen, which on the Wildfire are touch sensitive. Thankfully, unlike the Google Nexus One, these buttons are nice and responsive. We still maintain Android devices have too many buttons, but that's an argument for another time. Likewise, it's annoying to have to press the power button to activate the screen, rather than press any of these buttons that are already under your fingers. Though of course, being a smaller device than your average smartphone, the power button isn't as difficult to reach. The phone is finished in a combination of brushed metal and soft-touch plastic, and is put together very well, so it feels reassuringly solid. Also, the screen is finished in glass, so should resist scratches well, and again it gives the phone a quality feel. Even the buttons, which are also metal, feel securely fitted and have a nice action. HTC's now signature optical trackpad sits below the screen, and while it works as well as ever, we maintain it's still something of a superfluous extra. The big difference then between this phone and the likes of the HTC Desire and Samsung Galaxy S is its screen. At 3.2 inches from corner to corner, and with a resolution of just 240 by 320 pixels, is noticeably smaller and has a drastically lower resolution than those phones. Even through this video, you should be able to see that everything looks much grainier and slightly blurry on this device than on rival screens. This inevitably affects how easy it is to read text, and in particular makes browsing the web rather tedious, as you have to zoom in and out a lot. At least the web browser can be set to display text in a column, so there's less left to right scrolling. Likewise, this screen is definitely a bit small for watching large amounts of video, and doesn't really do photos justice. More importantly, many apps on the App Store don't support such a low resolution. However, don't let this put you off. The screen is still very much usable and the vast majority of everyday apps are compatible. The other big difference between this phone and larger smartphones is its slower processor. This is noticeable in everyday use, particularly in graphically intensive apps like Google Maps and the web browser. That said, the web browser does at least support Flash, even if it does struggle to play it back entirely smoothly. For the most part then, the Wildfire is exactly what the industry has been needing for a while. A small, low-cost smartphone that's just as packed with the important technology as the big guns, and doesn't compromise on build quality and usability.